Welcome to the Daily App Show iPhone Edition. We are going to take a look at Calorie Guard 2 today, an application that helps you keep track of your calories and your food consumption. So what we're looking at right now is my daily consumption for today, and it loads that up first. It goes to the current day because obviously that's where you're going to spend most of your time, is in the current day on this app. And so I can enter in additional items. I've already went ahead and set it up, but I'm going to show you here how I would enter in something. So, for example, let's say for lunch I'm going to have pizza. I'm going to get pizza with some friends. Up here we have favorites, meal, and sport activity. I entered in a whey shake into my favorites because that's something that I do every morning, and so it's a very often that I choose that one, and so rather than having to go and search for it all the time, I just added it to my favorites. So I'm going to tap on meal, and you can see here that there are tons of things in the database, and I'm just going to type in pizza and do a search. And so now it's brought up all the different types of pizza that I can choose from. And so let's say I had a Hawaiian chicken pizza, and I had two pieces of that. You could just adjust the slider, and it will go ahead and adjust that stuff. You could choose which meal it was. I'm going to go ahead and select lunch for that. And right here, if I wanted to add it to my favorites, I simply toggle that switch and hit on, and then hit OK, and it goes ahead and adds that. So it kind of gives me a happy face or a smile face or a sad face, depending on, you know, the calorie intake and everything. I mean, obviously, that was a lot of calories. And so I'm going to go ahead and add a sports activity. Let's say in the afternoon, I'm going to go to the gym, and I'm going to do some cycling. I do a lot of cycling at the gym, so I'm going to choose cycling for 60 minutes and hit OK. And so that's going to go ahead and obviously add calorie removal to my list. So I've entered in some stuff for yesterday as well, and so if I tap on statistics, I can see my daily statistics. I can also tap on weekly statistics and see graphs, and I could do that for month and half year also. So once you've started entering a lot of information into this application, after you've been using it for a few weeks, you're really going to start to see interesting data in that statistics tab with the week and the month, because you're going to be able to see how you're doing each day, and then of course kind of go back and say, okay, what did I do that day that resulted in additional calories, and maybe I should pay a little bit more attention, and or maybe you, with your calories, you need to work out a little bit harder to burn them off. So having everything recorded is really good. So in the overview tab, this is where we add information. We can also get a look at our daily consumption here. I'm at negative 52 calories now because of all of the cycling that I did at the gym. I have my remaining here. I have my weight here. So let's go into settings. There are some neat settings in this application. Here in the personal section, you would set up your information, and you can go into the miscellaneous tab and turn on metric units if you prefer to have metric units. So in personal, I'd enter in my information. I can also manually update the online database, which it will do automatically, but I can set it to do it more often if I would like. I can also synchronize here with the Withings body scale, and all of my measurements will sync automatically, so I don't have to enter weight anymore. It just automatically takes care of that. In the sync, this is really neat because this application works not only just with the iPhone, but with the iPad. And in another video, we're going to take a look at this app on the iPad. So if you have an iPad, make sure you check out that video. We can sync by Bluetooth our favorites and some of our information. So I'm going to go ahead and tap on Synchronize, and then I have my iPad off camera here, and I just went ahead and tapped for that as well. So it says that I've got my iPad here. I'm going to tap there and hit OK. And then, of course, after they connect to each other, I can hit Accept. and then I can send my favorites over to another device. So now you can see I'm connected to my iPad. I can send favorites. It asks me if that's okay on the other device. I hit no, or if I send favorites from the other device, I could hit yes here to accept those favorites and merge that information. So that's a pretty neat feature. So then I can disconnect when I'm done. We can also migrate this information over to CaloryGuard HD, which is the iPad version. And then we can export all of our statistics too through an email into a nice format so that we can view all of that stuff on our computer. Under statistics here, we have our percentages of our food intake and everything, and we can adjust those here. We can also hit reset to go back to defaults. And in miscellaneous, of course, I like this, the use badge for calories. So in the badge that shows up on the app icon when the app is closed, it will show how many calories you've consumed for the day. And that's pretty neat because you can see that badge all the time. And every time you go to your phone when you're thinking about, oh, what time is it? I'm getting kind of hungry or something. You can look at those calories and see where you're at and see how you're doing. In the About section, there's additional information about this app as well, including a manual you can get to up here. So this app, very nice, easy to use. I recommend using an app like this called Calorie Guard 2. So definitely also check out the video that we're putting together for the iPad as well to get a look at a much larger and, of course, iPad version of this app. So take care. We'll see you later. The Daily App Show.